Finding products to sell for your dropshipping store can be very hard and most people lose due to competition. Today, I will show you my own product research strategy that has generated me over hundreds of thousands of dollars in the past year. And if you follow this, you will find winning products. No more money wasted on advertisements that won't work. No more false hope from gurus promising you top 10 winning products. Here is how to actually find them for yourself. So what I'm looking for is a product that feels exclusive, has different features, looks unique, and stands out on social media feeds. When I'm trying to run ads for a product, I'm looking for a product that I can sell for at least 3 times the price and a minimum of $20 to $25 to make profit. And if I'm doing organic, I'm looking for products that I can easily make content with. They have a viral factor, like funny products, for example, and I can also get away with selling it a bit cheaper since the ad costs are not relevant. So I can sell for 2 times the price and a minimum of $10 to $15. Now let's look at where to find these products. My favorite and go-to strategy is the TikTok burner account. This means creating a complete new TikTok account with the sole purpose of product research and optimizing the algorithm to show me winning products. To do this, I search things such as TikTok made me buy it, Amazon finds, Amazon must-haves, I want a refund, and I interact with the content I find, whether it's by liking the pictures, saving, sharing, visiting the profiles of the accounts, and clicking on the links in their bios. This way, my For You page will be optimized and it will show me winning products without me having to look for anything. I also recommend searching different things other than TikTok made me buy it, because that is the strategy that every guru will tell you. Therefore, everyone that's trying to start dropshipping will go through that hashtag, which makes it very saturated. So I also like to look for seasonal stuff, such as, for example, Valentine's Day gift ideas. Valentine's Day was a couple of days ago, but let's pretend like it's an upcoming season. Boyfriend gift ideas, girlfriend gift ideas, winter must-haves, spring must-haves, Mother's Day gift ideas. This way you'll find less saturated products and also products that are in demand right now, which will make it easier for you to sell. So for example, now that Mother's Day is coming up kind of soon, I think maybe in May, but let's pretend like it was coming up kind of soon.
Okay.
I can look up Mother's Day gift ideas instead of just going with TikTok made me buy it. And as you can see here, many people are making compilations of things to get to your mom. So for example, this girl is showing this skincare product that you can find on AliExpress and dropship to and make a dropshipping store out of it. Same thing, this person is making a compilation of things you can find on Amazon to give to your mom. Here's another very trendy skincare product. Products like this, red light therapy has been a big trend recently. So as you can see, you get a lot of new ideas that are not the typical mini printer. And like I said, are very relevant to what's upcoming, which will make it easier for you to get your first sales. The second strategy I will recommend is one that I created myself. And to be honest, I have not seen anyone talk about this. So I would really suggest that you get on this, because this is a strategy where I found most of my winners recently and is what I like to call the Instagram burner account. So just like you would optimize your TikTok burner account, you optimize your Instagram reels to show you winning products. So this is a way you can do it. If you search on Instagram, TikTok made me buy it, you can again search other things as well, but this is just as an example. You'll get a lot of content. You'll get reels, accounts, and here you can find a lot of ideas for dropshipping products, which can be a good thing since when you are looking up stuff on TikTok, a lot of times it can get very repetitive. So if you change the platform, you can already get some new stuff. But what I like to do personally is I like to scroll through this hashtag, and just like I would with a burner account, I will like the videos, save them, and I like to actually share them to myself and just interact with a bunch of this content. So then when I go on my reels, it will just start showing me a lot of new winning products. So as you can see here, I'm always sharing myself winning products because I always happen to find really, really good ones on the Instagram reels. So this is a very underrated strategy that actually works really, really well. So I 100% would recommend you to try this. The third strategy is one of my recent favorites as well, and it's to use AutoDS. So AutoDS is actually a fulfillment platform for dropshipping, but they actually have a lot of other different features that I didn't know about. So if you go to their marketplace section, they have their best sellers, and here, pretty self-explanatory, they have the products that sell the best, which first of all is a great indicator that the products work, They might be a bit saturated, but you can always find good stuff here. And if you have a good marketing strategy and you also sell to a more untapped audience, then you can definitely make it work. So yes, for example, I think this dog towel is really, really great. I have not seen it before. So in this section, you can find a lot of great products that are proven to work. You can also go to the winning products section, which I really like. In this place, there's always new upcoming products. You can always find new stuff here. So it's great because it's not like the typical, again, TikTok made me buy a product. These are more untapped products as well. And you already have trustworthy suppliers in the platform. So for example, here I found this electric curtain thing that opens the curtains for you. And if you click on it, you can also research the market, which is great. It does it all for you. It tells you what the item costs, the potential profit, which is amazing, how much you can sell it for. And it also has this engagement score. So here you can see that the product is very, very active right now. People are engaging with products like this, which means that it's a trendy product right now. People are putting interest in this product. And it also has this saturation score, which is something that's very, very relevant. We don't want to sell oversaturated products, mostly if you're a beginner, because it's easier to compete when there's all of this pros that are already making so much money from one product that you're trying to sell. So here says that it's busy, which I think is great because there's that middle ground of it being proven to work. There's demand, but it's not crazy saturated yet. It tells you the target audience. So overall, it's amazing. And it also shows you some social media ads, people that are making content of it on TikTok. You can see competitors. It pretty much gives you everything. That's why I like this platform so much, because if I find a product and I want to validate it, it just does it all for me. So if you want to try this method, you can use the link in my description and it will give you a 30-day free trial so that you can just give it a go. It gives you all of these different tools, so I feel like it's very, very worth it. And the last place that I look to find my products is AliExpress. I like AliExpress because first of all, it's free, and if you optimize it correctly, it can show you a lot of really, really good stuff. AliExpress is great to also find products that are not so saturated and that people have not even tested before. So if you're looking to jump into a new trend, you don't want to try something that's crazy saturated, I feel like AliExpress can be a great way to go. So if you go to AliExpress and you scroll down, there's this section here called More to Love, and this is kind of like the for you page of AliExpress. So it will optimize the words what you engage with. So for me, since I'm always looking at winning products for dropshipping, it shows me a lot of that. But for you, it might not be so optimized. But as you start looking for dropshipping products, your More to Love page will start looking a lot like this. And if you want to optimize your More to Love page, all you have to do is just open the products that you find in new tabs if you know they're dropshipping products. That way, it'll just start showing you more. Like I said, it's optimized towards what you engage with. So here, I have already found a lot of cool products that could work amazing, and I have not seen so much on TikTok. A lot of trendy products. So yes, just by scrolling a little bit on my AliExpress More to Love, I have already found some really, really good stuff. So for example, I found this product that I have seen a couple of times on my Instagram reels, and it's for the Stanley Cup, which is a very, very trendy. I feel like everyone has the Stanley Cup right now. So this is just like an add-on for it where you can put your snacks. So we are already using something that's very trendy that everyone has, that everyone goes crazy for. I don't know why it's just a cup, but I don't understand. But yeah, and we are selling some accessories for it that are very fun. So yes, this is just a tray for your snacks. I think it works really well for TikTok organic. Somehow people love it. So yeah, maybe it's a little bit weird, but if it looks fun and it has that viral factor, then people are definitely gonna be interested on it. And as I said, if it involves something that's very trendy, people are gonna love it. I also found this LED mirror for your car. There's also this big trend of the passenger princess. So if you start marketing as something for your passenger princess, then I think this can work really, really good. So yeah, it's just like a mirror to maybe do your makeup on the car. It's all about having a trendy marketing angle or just finding a way to make a product go viral. And lastly, I found this, I don't know how to explain it, but it's a drum kit where you can just play the drums in the air and you put your headphones on and it just sounds like you're playing drums. is really cool. So as you can see, this product has that crazy wow factor. It's very unique and very cool, and I literally just found it by optimizing my AliExpress correctly and just scrolling. So I would definitely recommend to try it for yourself. It might take a little bit of time for your AliExpress to be optimized, but it's definitely worth the try. Okay, so now that I've given you 4 different strategies on how to find products, I'm gonna tell you how to validate them. How do you make sure that this product is good and worth selling? First of all, I always recommend, mostly if you're a beginner, to have a list of the criteria that I mentioned earlier on your side written down. So each time you find a product, you can ask yourself these questions. First, is it a unique and exclusive product? If you think that this product can be easily found at the mall, at Walmart, or yeah, it's just a product that you have seen many times before, then maybe it's not worth running. Second, does this product serve a purpose? Third, would this product stand out on social media feeds? Four, does this product have a viral factor? Five, can I sell this for 2 times or 3 times the price? If all of the answers are yes, then it's a good potential product and you should go for it. As for the saturation, one way I like to see if the products I want to run are saturated is just by looking them up on TikTok. So for example, if I look up super saturated product like the mini printer on TikTok, I will know that it's just not worth running. If it's all over TikTok shop, there's so many people making content of it. Something I also like to look at is the user. This way I can see all of the organic accounts that are trying to run it. So yeah, it's crazy amount of people are trying to run this product. So I would definitely not go for it. But if I look at something that's a little bit more untapped, like for example, now I looked up the Stanley snack holder. People are not selling this on TikTok shop, first of all, which is great. There is some content of it, but mostly just reviews or people that got it for themselves. It doesn't matter if people have reviews of the product as long as they're not selling them. So one way I can look if people are selling this product is by going on the users again. These are organic accounts that are trying to dropship this product. And as you can see, compared to the mini printer, there's not that many accounts and most of them have like 2 followers. So I don't think it's much competition. So that's actually just how I check if my products are very saturated or worth running. And it's just a very simple and free way. Something I like to do as well is to go on Google Trends to check the demand of the products. So in this place, if you don't know, Google Trends is just a website where you can search something and see if people are looking it up. So for example, I can look up Stanley Cup. I'm not saying you should dropship the Stanley Cup because that's already an established brand and you would probably get copyright issues, but you can sell the snack holder. So as you can see, I can look up whatever I'm trying to dropship. I can look up worldwide, or if you're trying to dropship to one specific country, you can search it up here as well. And you can search how much people are searching for the product in the past hour, the past day, the past month. I like to go the past month or sometimes the past week. As you can see, this is a very trendy topic. And if we see the past 90 days, it kind of just blew up. And also here, you can search for the Google Shopping to see how many people are interested in buying a product like this. So yeah, as you can see here, the trend is pretty steady. It's dying out a bit recently, but you can search for your dropshipping product here to see if people are interested and if there's demand right now. You can also see here on the graph if it looks as if it's gonna blow up, if it's gonna be a trend, then that's a very good sign as well. So yeah, that's pretty much everything I like to do when it comes to my product research. These are all the strategies that I personally use to find my winners, and they work amazing for me. And I'm sure that if you follow them step by step, they will work for you too. So I hope you liked this video. I hope it was helpful. If you liked it, make sure to click a like and subscribe. Follow me on my Instagram because I'm always posting more content about my stores and everything that has to do with my life and e-com. And if you want to learn more, you can subscribe to this channel because I post videos every single week.